Hey Zoo family, it's just Timmy and I today. We are heading to Walmart to do some back to school last minute shopping. I have to pick up a couple surprises for him that he doesn't know yet, but I know he's gonna be super excited. Pick backpacks out. We're gonna pick backpacks up. Let's go pick one out for you.
Rebel and Chase.
That's the one you want?
Yes.
Well, that was fast. Honestly, I thought that would take way longer, but he likes Paw Patrols, so that's what he picked out, and that was like the first one that he saw.
Hey, do you have my baseball?
No.
What?
It's just like stuffing. Oh, don't do that. You're making a mess now. Whoa, look at you, buddy. I can't believe you're like this old. How is it possible that you look so cute in a backpack? I can't handle this. Okay, next on our to-do list is to pick a water bottle out.
I am all of them.
All of them? You need to pick one.
All of the Aston Fiddles.
Yeah, look at this one. Look, you've got Chase and Marshall on it. You want all of them? Okay, this one has all of them. Is that the one you want?
No, I don't.
It doesn't have sky on it?
Yeah. It needs sky.
It needs sky. How about this one? That one's not heavy. You can carry that one. How about that one?
I want sky.
You want sky on it?
Yeah.
Of course you want sky on it. Doesn't make any sense why they didn't have sky on it. There you are. There it is. We found it. Is that it? Did we figure it out, Timmy? Did we figure it out?
Yeah.
Yeah, awesome. High five. Woohoo! Okay, for you cute kid. Look at that cutie. Oh my.
Whoa!
Mommy's heart is breaking. Next on our to-do list is shoes. Shoes, Paw Patrol shoes. Of course, it's Paw Patrol shoes. Be so heartbroken when he starts school. I can't even, like, I was getting teary-eyed just thinking about it, because he's my baby. I can't even think about it right now.
I'm not gonna say it.
You're not? What, please?
No.
Can you please tell me?
No.
No. I think he's getting shy.
Go home.
He just said, Mommy, can you please drop me off to school? Huh. Somebody's super excited to start school. Are you excited for school?
Yeah, and I talked to an Aider-gade.
Some Aider-gade is what he calls it.
Yeah, and told you.
It is freezing cold, huh?
Yeah, it's hot out here.
It is so hot outside. So I took Timmy shopping earlier today to get some school supplies, and we have had so many comments that we just decided we would do a mini Q&A and talk about why the other three are being homeschooled and why Timmy is going to preschool this year.
It's because we love Timmy more.
Of course not. Are you serious? There's no preferential treatment here. If you're not aware, we live in Florida, and in Florida, pre-K 4 for 4-year-olds is paid for free. All you got to do is go to the pre-K institution you want to choose, and if you can get a spot, like an open spot, and sign your kid up, they can go to pre-K free for a year. And even before we started taking advantage of that program, Caleb was in pre-K 3. In fact, Caleb went to pre-K 3, pre-K 4, and kindergarten in private school before Melanie and I made the decision to consider homeschooling. Regardless, we've put every kid through pre-K 4 because it's free. By the way, it's not just because it's free. We realized it does something really cool, which is it gives them a year outside of the home to do a lot of basic growing that you can only do kind of when you're in a classroom full of kids and you have to learn some social skills and maybe face a little bit of miniature adversity when someone steals your toy or something and gets away with it, maybe. We try not to let kids get away with that stuff here at home. You know, he's going to learn to deal with some stuff, and he's going to mature a lot in 1 year. And each of our kids has done that. They've gone, like I said, Caleb actually did it through kindergarten. But Logan also went to pre-K 4, and then we brought him home the next year for homeschool, and then we'll do that with Timmy too. After this year of pre-K 4, Timmy will come home and be homeschooled like everyone else, but it'll give him a good foundational year. They also learn a lot of cool things like the basics of sitting in a classroom and that stuff.
Basic classroom rules.
Yeah, that's actually harder to teach than you would think it would be anyway. That also means Melanie doesn't have to worry about that basic stuff. So when Melanie starts homeschooling him, he'll already have that basic foundation of what it's like to learn and go to a class and sit and raise your hand and keep your hands to yourself, mind the rules, things like that. And he'll also kind of get a feel for the daily schedule, the daily routine. Yeah. So we've done that with all the boys. And then Katie obviously came home at 7 years old, quite a few years after pre-K 4. And we had talked about like maybe putting her in school for a year, but the problem is if you put her in public school for a year, they're going to immediately put her into a program called ESOL, and she won't even be on the same learning schedule as everyone else. It's a whole different program because she's learning English as a second language. They wouldn't, by the way, tutor her in her original language. They don't even have Bengali speaking teachers in the program. What ESOL means, it's just kind of like a remedial type of program. It would not have been customized to her age necessarily. She would have had to attend school part-time with the rest of the class, right?
And it would have taken her 4 years to get through the program.
Yeah. Oh my goodness.
4 years.
That's right. The person we talked to at the time anyways told us it's a minimum of 4 years in that program before you even get on to the standard track, before you get caught up.
It's crazy.
We believe Cadence will probably be caught up in terms of like her English and grammar and mathematics skills. She will probably get caught up to the Abeka curriculum in about 2 years, 2.5 years. So the way we figure, we can do it twice as fast by doing it ourselves. And that will benefit Cadence because she can get onto a normal schedule that will ultimately lead to a better foundation being laid for middle school and high school. We didn't want to see her take 4 years to get caught up, which would be the end of elementary school for her. And then she'd have to basically only get onto a normal schedule or a normal curriculum in middle school. So when people say, why didn't you try and put her into public school?
We had talked about it.
We had definitely talked about it. We just knew that by starting Cadence off with whatever year we choose, start her there and then work through that curriculum. And maybe instead of doing a year for that one grade level, do it in 9 months or do it in 8 months, whatever speed she can comfortably move at.
And she's already moving through the curriculum faster than what we thought.
We took her for an evaluation back in May, and they recommended, based on where she sounded like she was at with her vocabulary and just her ability to communicate, that we could start her off in first grade curriculum. So essentially the goal will be that we get her to first grade as soon as possible here in the next couple of months. And then 2 years from now, where you would say, well, add two to that, 2 years from now, isn't she starting the third grade? Well, no, in order to catch her up, that means 2 years from now, hopefully we would be close to, if not already starting the fifth grade. And that probably freaks Melanie out because you're talking
it's
about four grade levels in 2 years. But we know people who said, you know, their kid wasn't fully caught up until like high school. And the reason they say that is because you focus more on your basic subjects, your mathematics and your English.
Yeah.
And then you work so hard on those to get them caught up. By the time they are caught up, you realize, well, now I got to go back and teach history. I haven't taught any American history. Or if I have taught American history, it's been minimal compared to the full curriculum. Well, now that they're caught up and they can, you know, let's say in 2 years from now, she starts reading and math at the fifth grade level, we might still be at the third grade level for history, and we have to go back, or for science, and we have to go back and still keep moving her forward in those areas. One more thing that's important to note is, in addition to us not doing that basic out of the house pre-K4 style single year of education for Cadence, She did go to a school for a time when she was in India, so she did get the foundation. So when she came home, she was able to go right into homeschool. And when we went into the homeschool room, she took her seat, she grabbed her pencil, and she was like, okay, tell me what to do. What are we doing? Like, she knew what to do. So the foundation was already there. So she really doesn't need, for the same reasons, need that extra year outside of the house to learn how to be a student the way Timmy does and Logan did and Caleb benefited from. So that's why we're doing what we're doing. It's not that Timmy's going to be on a different program. It's just Timmy's paying his dues in order to be a good homeschool student. He's learning in pre-K 4 how to follow rules, how to have a backpack, very little how to do homework, because toward the second half of the year they start sending home a little assignment now and then. It's like, take this home and color it and bring it back the next day. It's so basic. Or write your name on this paper and bring it back. It's so basic, but it's important stuff. And when you add in the fact our state offers it for free,
it's a no-brainer.
Why would we not do this? So it'll be great for Timmy. So that's it for this video. We hope that answered some questions. We know this is not your typical vlog style, seeing us just sit in front of a camera and talk. The talking heads, we know a lot of people actually hate that, but we know that's really necessary to tell you if you want to know what's going on in our life. That's why Timmy's going to school the way he is. So before we go, though, we have a question of the day. We came up with it all on our own, and it has to do with homeschool. And it's not your typical question of the day, because most questions of the day are like your opinion. Today, we're asking you to guess the answer. So what's the question?
So in the next couple weeks, there's going to be a homeschool announcement for my big kids. And so today, I want to know, what change do you think we're going to make for this coming homeschool year?
What an open-ended question.
If you're going to give me suggestions, I'm like, oh, well, or maybe we can do that next year.
Maybe we're fishing for suggestions. I'll give you a hint. This is something we've always known we would do. We've been talking about it for a long time, and we're finally committing to doing it. And it is basically taking homeschool and adding something to it. So that's it. No more hints. That's all you're going to get. That's the question of the day. What change do you think is coming to homeschool for the Chandler household? Shout out to Shivam Gupta, who found the hidden zoo animal in yesterday's video and tagged it in his answer to the question of the day. We ask, what brings back fond memories for you? Shivam said visiting his home village in India brings back fond memories, particularly childhood memories of climbing fruit trees and seeing livestock. He says it fills him with contentment. Don't forget to tag the hidden zoo animal from today's video in your answer to the question of the day, and we may give you a shout out in our next video. Don't forget to like,
comment,
share,
subscribe,
and we'll see you tomorrow.
Bye.